Ever wondered why an astronaut floats in space? Why does an apple fall from a tree, but a helium balloon rises? These are not random occurrences, but the result of fundamental principles governing our universe. It's all about Newton's laws of motion. Intrigued? Stay tuned. Picture this: a soccer ball at rest will remain at rest unless you give it a nudge. This is the essence of Newton's first law of motion, or the law of inertia. It simply means that objects will keep doing what they're doing until something causes them to do otherwise. Like a book on a shelf will stay put until you pull it down, or a car will continue to move until the brakes are applied. That's Newton's first law for you. Objects prefer to keep on doing what they're doing. Have you ever noticed how harder it is to push a heavy sofa than to push a light chair? This is a perfect example of Newton's second law of motion. It tells us that the force applied to an object is equal to the mass of the object multiplied by its acceleration. If we think about it, a light chair, with less mass, accelerates more easily than a heavy sofa. In essence, the heavier the object, the more force needed to move it. That's Newton's second law. The force on an object equals its mass times its acceleration. Ever experience the jolt when you jump off a small boat onto the shore? That's Newton's third law of motion in action. It's the law of action and reaction. When you leap from the boat, you push it backwards. That's the action. The boat pushes back with an equal force in the opposite direction, causing you to move forward. That's the reaction. It's the same reason why you move backwards when you fire a gun. That's Newton's third law. For every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. So, what's the big deal about these laws? Newton's laws of motion are the bedrock of physics, the ABCs of motion, if you will. They help us comprehend and anticipate how objects move. Newton's laws, they're not just rules, but the very language of motion itself.